I recognize that some people feel diminished by geologic time, that humans are made insignificant by it, and I can understand that. I think it helps to start developing some depth of field in thinking about time. I had a math teacher who was fond of saying there are many sizes and shapes of infinity. And while geologic time is not infinite, it is long. Some past events, like the Pleistocene, the Ice Age, happened just the other day. Others, say the formation of Pangaea, a while ago, and some, the origin of life, for instance, a long time back. It's also useful to adopt the Greek distinction between chronos, raw time, billions and billions of years, and kairos, which is time within a narrative. As one starts knowing Earth's story, and those vast stretches of geologic time are filled with narratives, protagonists, and plot lines, it's no longer alienating. The characters become familiar, the themes resonant. Once we open a few volumes in the library of deep time, we can begin to recognize ourselves in the tales of earlier Earthlings. Indeed, I find the idea of a 7,000 or 8,000-year-old Earth with a shallow, short history positively terrifying, while the enveloping presence of so many ancestors with such a rich anthology of life stories to share is, to me, deeply comforting.